The first language of human species has been the topic of different discussions for several years. Apparently, there is no data that shows exactly the way of the human language has been taken. According to Charles Darwin, early humans had acquired the process of sharing their loves by using musical notes and not by using the language that we know in these times. However, that's still a speculation, which it means that we don't have direct evidence to prove that. And therefore, there are so many assumptions that we can take in order to know how the language is originated. The first theory that we're going to study is the divine source, which many societies throughout history believed that language was given by God. In Christianity, God gave to Adam, the king of all the animals, and the first thing that he did was to name these animals. A few experiments have been carried out in order to rediscover this divine language. They believed that if a child was in isolation, the first word that he would say would be in the divine language. However, the child was affected by the lack of communication about the interaction with the humans. The second theory is the natural sound source. This is based on the concept of natural sound, which is the ability to identify sounds in the environment and allowing people to make a connection between the sound and the thing that produces that sound. And this is divided into two parts. Hello. The first part is the baobab theory, which it says that nature and the animal sounds are the starting point of the language systems. And it says that vocabulary comes from the imitation of the animal sounds, such as moo, bark, meow meow, or quack. However, the language is more than a set of names, and these sounds are known as onomatopoeia. And the second part is the poo-poo theory, which holds that through emotional response, a language and a speech will have developed in relation with the human reactions, such as anger, or pain, or joy, etc. And some examples of these sounds are O for surprise and ouch for pain. However, these sounds are not necessarily included in the vocabulary of humans. The third theory is the social interaction source. Early human beings used some kind of sounds in order to communicate with each other when they were doing some collaborative work. For example, when they were lifting a huge animal. They did this because they wanted to reach that message to the other friends and to coordinate all the physical efforts. The main part of this theory is that human beings were in social groups and they somehow had to use the language, even if they were just grunts or grounds. However, apes live in social groups, but they don't have developed the human language as the way we use. The fourth theory is the physical adaptation source. Unlike humans, no other species can use the language as we do, because they have different physical characteristics than humans. For example, a human mouth is smaller, which makes it easier in order to open it and close it for fast speed prediction. Humans have a vocal tract for speaking. The teeth of humans are in oral position in order to do some sounds, to produce some sounds such as and v. And also the tongue can move backwards, forwards, up and down in order to produce different sounds. And in fact, without these physical features, we are not able to speak. The fifth theory is the tool-making source. This theory holds that Immanuel Jesu may have been a precursor of language. And the human brain is really important in this theory because it has some specialized functions that can control the language and the tool using. And both are located in the left hemisphere in the brain. And this theory involves the ability to take two rocks and put them together in order to create something. So the same happens with the language. And this is the last theory, the genetic source. This is also called the innateness hypothesis. And it is based on the fact that children are wired with some kind of capacity to produce sounds. And it is thought that in our brains it may contain a kind of a language gene that allows us to produce the speech. And it is something very exclusive to humans because other creatures don't have the ability or this innate capacity. The origin of language is still a mystery because it hasn't been proved yet. But based on the different sources that we have seen, I can say that it's a combination of each one, making an exception in the divine source. Because let's face it, the language cannot be developed by isolation. And stronger theories could be the physical adaptation source, because we have the essential characteristics in order to be able to speak. From the moment that we walk in an upright position, everything changed and all the elements work together in order to produce the speech. And also the tool making source will be important because the brain has been through a process of evolution and it's connected with the tool using and that we can be able to speak. And the last one will be the genetic source, because due to the DNA genetics, we have an innate ability to speak. And some research proved that a gene mutation makes possible the process of speech and the process of language. So now, it's your turn to figure out where the language comes from.